What's up, YouTube? My name is Dell. This is Dell on Movies. Welcome to my channel. If you've been here before, welcome back. Thanks for hanging out with me, spending some of your precious time with me. I truly appreciate it. And this is another episode of Watch These Movies. This is where I recommend some movies to you guys that maybe a little bit obscure, maybe not completely obscure, but it's something that I feel is underseen. Movies that I feel are underseen, need to be seen by more people. They're good stuff. And I like to start with something kind of tame and then work my way over to the opposite end of the spectrum. So let's just go ahead and dive right into it. The first movie is called Race. Came out a few years back. This movie is about Olympic legend Jesse Owens. If you don't know who he was, look him up. I'll tell you a little bit. He won 4 gold medals in the 1936 Berlin Olympics. Really significant because this was right when Hitler was coming into power, or shortly after he came into power in Germany, and he was really going hard on the superior race thing, and just really thought that the Germans were gonna just destroy everybody at the Olympics, especially track and field. And Jesse Owens basically was the hope to represent the country. He did so, but then his life after the Olympics, kind of a tragic life, not one that you would think he would lead after that. So the movie's, again, it's not a Disney movie, but it's kind of a Disneyfied, I call it Disneyfied version of events. It's kind of tame, and but it in kind of watered down a little bit for family consumption, but it is pretty good. It's a solid movie. There's probably a more epic movie that could be made from it, but this works. The next recommendation is a movie called Traitor, and Traitor stars Don Cheadle and Guy Pearce. Guy Pearce is an FBI agent, and he's investigating a prison break that happened in Yemen that was done by some terrorist organization, and it looks like they had help from an American spy, and it looks like Don Cheadle is that spy. So basically, this is Guy Pearce chasing Don Cheadle. It's flew under the radar back when it came out. It's definitely a good one, definitely one that needs to be seen. So I know a lot of people haven't even heard of this one, despite who stars in the movie. So yeah, check out Traitor. Next one is a movie I saw way back when I was a kid. It came out back in 1975, actually, believe it or not. And I saw it probably early 80s. There's another one that I saw with some of my older family members that was just hanging out with them, and they were watching it. And this one is called Hard Times, starring, you can see Charles Bronson right there on the cover, and James Coburn is also the other main character in there. Charles Bronson plays a bare knuckle fighter. He's way back in the day, he's just going bare, not legally, he was just fighting on the streets for money. James Coburn becomes his manager, starts to try to get him into different, a little more lucrative fights. And the two have a kind of a rough relationship. It's a fantastic movie. James Coburn absolutely kills it in this movie. He carries the film. Bronson is Bronson. I've never thought he was a great actor, but he does pretty good here. But Coburn really, really kills the movie. If you're into fighting movies, this is not technically a boxing movie, but it's pretty close. They're boxing just without gloves. So check out Hard Times. Again, it came out in the 70s. Bare knuckle fighting. I don't think it's on Blu-ray for any of my collectors out there. If it is, let me know, because I would love to get this on Blu-ray rather than DVD. But hey, as it is, I'll watch it just like this and be perfectly fine. Next one, I'm going to go into some horror. Horror and it is a genre where there's just so much out there, you just can't see it all. This one is called The Ruins, and we got some college kids here in this one, and don't all the best horror movies star college kids or high school kids and just getting destroyed? Well, that's kind of what happens here. In this case, they decide to go to some Mayan ruins and check things out. They heard some legends about the place. And when they get there, well, they find out the legends are really interesting. I'm getting ahead of myself a little bit. So they actually get to this place, and when they're trying to leave, a bunch of locals surround them so that they can't leave. And then the movie progresses from there. So you kind of, I don't want to give anything else away, but it is a really, really good movie, actually. When it came out, there were some people that were singing his praises, but a lot of people didn't see it. So yeah, go back and check out The Ruins. You can get it cheap. I think I got this for $3, maybe $5 at Big Lots, and they're usually multiple copies of it there, so you can definitely get your hands on it for just a few bucks. So no excuse to check out not to check out Ruin, The Ruins. And my la number five, my last recommendation for this week's episode is a Korean movie called I Saw the Devil. So this is one of the wildest, craziest revenge movies I've ever seen. It's brutally violent right from the get-go. The guy's face on the outside here, that you can see when you're looking at the cover, there's a there's a face, a split, and then you see another face on the inside. The guy on the outside is a police officer, and right at the beginning of the movie, his wife. He was at an event. He had to work an event. He was like Secret Service, more or less, not just a regular cop. So he's working, and his wife is driving somewhere. She hits car trouble, and while she's actually on the phone with him, she gets brutally murdered. She's just killed. The guy who did it is this face right here. And if you've seen Old Boy, iconic Korean movie, it's the same guy who played the main character in that movie. So he's the killer. Of course, after some investigation, he decides to the cop decides to go after the killer himself, off the books kind of thing. So he takes vacation because, of course, they won't let him work the case because it's his wife. So he takes vacation or time off and goes to work on the case himself. And finds out that not only did this guy kill his wife, but he's actually a full-blown serial killer. And then he just winds up chasing this guy all over the country, and he often catches the guy. So and I won't say any more other than that, other than if you a fan of brutally violent action slash horror movies, this is one that you have to check out. It's a fantastic movie. I know it is on Blu-ray. I just don't have it yet. One of these days I'll upgrade that too. But it's well worth the watch, no matter what format you watch it on. So yeah, I Saw the Devil is yeah, get your hands on that one. So that's all I have for you guys. Let me know what you think of any of those movies, if you've seen them, or if you decide to watch them after watching this video. I hope you do. Can definitely have a conversation down in the comment section. Like, comment, subscribe, do all those things, and we can continue having chats about movies. And so that's all I got for you on this one, guys. I'll catch you on the next one. Bye.